Hey guys, this is Troy, and I just wanted to share some secrets with you about how to set up your kennel and how to kennel train. Very easy, quick step, just throw a treat in the back, from the back or to the back, and play a fetch game. So we're gonna do that now with Gus, my puppy Gus. Hopefully the camera will stay with me. And so I got a wide angle right now because I just wanna focus on the resetting up the kennel and everything. This is his current kennel. I was able to get a really nice kennel with two handles right here for $35 from a Goodwill off a Circle here in Colorado Springs. And the only thing about it is the tray is busted. So just so happens that these kennels are the same size. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this out, and I just want to use it, you know? I want to use it and let's see, where's it at here? Not sure why it's getting stuck, but I'm just gonna put this one up anyways. Might as well set it up. I'll probably take these off maybe. I'm not sure why it's not working. Anywho, so probably the little insert right here. Let's see if I can get that out. There we go. I'll just put that over here. And yeah, it even has the paperwork and everything. It was crazy. I was like, wow, okay. So, something that you can do is to put your workout clothes. You know, say you got some old workout clothes that you're gonna throw out. Really, any clothes that you're gonna throw out. What you could do is to go ahead and set this up. What you could do, man, this is a brand new kennel. It's gonna switch those trays out. But what you can do is, I think it's a beautiful thing to you know, use it up, wear it out, make do or do without. So you'll see in here, there's by bring this forward a little bit, or backwards, and then this forward a little bit. Guess you want to come out and hang out? Let's play. So I've got some socks, I've got some old ripped up jeans, and I've got some shorts that I sweated in, I did a workout in. And you know, you can kind of cycle these out maybe every 2 weeks to a month. And but for right now, I just want to put that right there. This little mat, little bed. I'm gonna get everything out of here. Here we go. Okay, so that's gonna go on top for now, and then I'll set the door in. Here we go. Push this little arm out, and then come up. Out and up with it. Now I can break this. You can break this down. I'll wash that. But it's a really powerful thing to do to reward with your scent, especially if you know you're going out of town or you know something like that's going on. You're gonna be gone for you know 5 hours or less. So I'm gonna take this out of the way. Oh, excuse me. Good boy. Good puppy. And then so that's gonna go over here. While I'm setting this up and moving it. Good here. And I always like to leave a little space. So I've got a little space over here. So if I want to basically slide that kennel to the right. That's another option. I like to put them on top and just have like a flat surface. So let me see if I can get this again. There we go. All right, now we're moving again. Let's see if it zoom in here. No zooming. But anywho, so what a good boy. He's all sitting down here.
Wow.
Abajo?
Yeah, abajo.
Good boy.
Abajo. No. Quedarse. Quieto. Stay.
So we're learning how to be bilingual. And that's really good for if your dog's lost, you know, someone can actually call them or call them by their name or
ven aquí, come here, you know, come here.
Yeah, good boy.
Ooh, get it. Get
it. Yeah, what a good jump.
Yeah, good boy.
Okay, so we're gonna feed Gussie. But and this thing is not following me that well. So essentially what I want to do is to load this old tray in there. I'll wash everything down and move the kennel, vacuum it out and everything about every 2 weeks to a month. And so just kind of putting that down. And now, bam, putting that in there. And there's this little kind of like an upside down L shape, almost like a...
It's okay.
And so I'm going to want to do that. I'm going to push the kennel forward and up and that in and out. And then if you really want to, you can kind of push it back there and you can drill out those things and or put rivets in it with little holes in there.
Yeah, good boy. Want to get in your new kennel? Oh my gosh, look at that new kennel. Get in the kennel. Yeah, good boy.
So they've got two new doors. They've got a side door right here, which is really cool. So that's why I bought this kennel. I was actually looking for it and trying to get one, and I just couldn't find one. So, it's that. Bam. I'm just going to look at the tolerances and everything.
There we go.
That's good there. There we go. Okay.
Now we get some foodies.
Yeah.
Good boy.
I just got this new food. So I'm gonna reward him with that. Pre-stage that. And then I'm just gonna put this one, right back in there, you know? There's no sense in not having it in there and storing it somewhere else. Unless you want this tray to be on the very top. That's another way to do it. You know, we can try that. That way it's kind of removable. And it strengthens this top part of the kennel up. And you can kind of stagger it too, which is kind of cool. You kind of stagger those two to where they're almost like three-dimensional.
Good boy, Gussie, what a good puppy.
Yeah.
Right at the, wait. Okay.
Good boy. So I'll put this on top. It's got a few holes in it. It's got a little hole right here. And then it's got a big old large crack right here. So I'm just going to put that on top.
Siéntate. Good boy.
And then I'm going to get all his treats and everything. Come back up here. Bam. You can put this... you can actually use these to extend and do something like this, you know? So that's how I set it up if I'm coming right back, or at night, if I want him to have access. He can lay down right here, actually, if he wants to be on the carpet, and then he can get some water, and you know, maybe a little bit of food, maybe you throw a, you know, couple handfuls. Yeah, foodies, huh?
You want your foodies?
Yeah!
Good boy.
So I'm gonna open his food up.
Yeah, he's so excited.
You're so excited. Oh, you just can't hide it. You know.
Sit down.
So I'm actually going back to Victor. Victor Foods. They're a really good brand.
here we go. Put that in the trash. Good boy. Oh, good sin.
So I always want to reward him for everything. You know, let him taste the new food. Ooh,
smaller kibble. Ooh, yummy. The purple dog food. Ooh, yeah.
So this is classic. It's got, let's see, it's got 81% protein from meat sources and only 16 from grain sources, 3% protein from plants and veggies. So it's got a good mixture here. Yeah, is that good?
Oh, good boy.
Oh, good puppy. All right, so lifting my legs off the back. And this will be titrated into his old food so it doesn't mess up his stomach. And then later in the week, I'll probably go buy that last bag. And, woohoo, guess. Yeah,
I'm so excited, yeah.
That's it. So, what I'll do is I'll usually notate it on my whiteboard here. And then, write down Victor Classic, and then usually 81% protein, just to make sure. You know, if I can't get this brand, it really helps to have an alternative that's as close as possible to the content of the food that you're actually using. Even if you can't, you know, let's say, you know, you can't find the brand, it's not here. This is actually at Big R, but I got this at Ace Hardware, so I could walk across the street at my place, and I can actually go there with Gus, which is really cool. And, you know, we get our food.
Oh my gosh, are you ready? Ooh.
And so, I've got a full gallon bag, nearly, of his old food, which is still really good. And so I'm going to put that in here. I'm going to kind of pop it to the back. And then I want to give him just one cup. So it's going to be a 2-to-1 ratio titrating from 2 cups of this. But this is actually half a cup, legitimately a half of a cup. Right? And you can weigh it out too, to be even more accurate with your dog's ratio, you know, their diet, for the ratio of their diet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put 2 in there. New food. Oh yeah. Want to get your kennel? Oh, good boy. Woo. So I'm gonna get that new food in there, and I'm gonna go for the old food. There we go. All right. So that'll be good. And sometimes I like to preload one, and that way it's really easy, and I just put it in there, bam, I can just grab that, even if I don't have, you know, I can do this one-handed if I really needed to, holding Gus anywhere, here, you know, outside, anywhere. So I'm going to mix this up, put a little bit of coconut oil in there, because he loves that. This is actually Dr. Bronner's organic virgin coconut oil. And it's really, really good. So I'm just gonna get, you know, just the average size teaspoon and put it in there. Mmm. Oh, yummy. And it's so good for them. It's good for their coat. It's good for the health of, you know, the overall health. Mmm, yeah. And it's a good treat too. You know, you can keep a dog's attention even under full distraction. If you have a small thing of coconut oil, you could even put water in here to kind of make them slow down. So you don't really need a bowl, like a slow feeder bowl or anything like that. But I like the Nida feeder. It's really cool. Sit. Good boy. Abajo. Down. Good boy. Speak. Yeah. Okay. So he was waiting pretty good today. So it is right at 9:40 this morning, and Yeah, she's such a good boy. So, I recommend putting your food in the closet of some sort. So, it's up off the ground. It's got secondary containment as far as, you know, if anything gets in there, it's just sealed. So I'm gonna do that after I get off camera. But if you have any questions about feeding schedules or weighing things out, I've actually got two scales here that, you know, I can kind of tear and see, you know, what that weight is gonna be, you know, as I'm feeding them. So that's something that I'm gonna implement with this black scale here. So yeah, if you have any questions, if you're trying to do kennel training, the essence of the training is to have an empty kennel at first, to have a hard reset as far as what the kennel means to them, and that what we're trying to do is make this as a den. We're trying to make it as comfortable as possible. So even relook, you know, finding where your dog is when they're perfectly relaxed, you know, do they go to the fan by the window? Do they go by the door, right? Are they waiting for someone? Kind of think about those things. And don't be afraid to, you know, pack up your kennel and relocate it to that area where they feel comfortable. Because that's gonna, doing that is gonna kind of reinstitute those calm, you know, the least amount of anxiety and the most amount of calmness as possible for your dog. Especially if you're moving, if anyone's away on vacation, you know, my son goes from our house to his mom's house, so there's a lot of changes in the pack dynamics and in your family and your friends. You know, when friends come over, if they come over with dogs, you know, they can come over with dogs, and that kennel can be a source of a peace and comfort and tranquility, because that's what a den or a kennel or a denel I might start using that. But you know, the kennel is, it's a beautiful thing. Good boy, Gussie, good boy. And, I really love it. I really love, utilizing a kennel. And, you can even kind of go like this and use that as a full door opener and, prop it up, that divider. For your kennel, if you're, you know, you can get a, what I recommend is never to get a small kennel. You can if you want to, if it's super cute, if it's red, blue, green, you know, yellow, primary colors are really powerful. Blue or yellow are what a dog can see the best. And then they can see shades of dark to light, you know, gray, white, black. But a good boy, you got it, good boy, and just praise them. You know, after they get that first meal, that new food, they're like, oh, that was so good, ooh. You know, their product placement, you know, for what they're going through as far as, like, the satiation of food, and, like, food is such a tether. So that tether needs to be stronger than the highest distraction that you can encounter. So I don't recommend dog parks. I recommend a park and taking your dog there. But a lot of times it's such a high distraction and there's so many smells and so many things going on, so much information, that it's hard for your dog to listen to you. Like they do in their kennel, you know, like they do at home, like they do, you know, like you feel that they do in their heart. And so it's kind of disconcerting when they have a bad day, you know, and they're aggressive, or they're, you know, try to, you know, pulling on the leash, or they're whining excessively, you know, oh yeah, oh my gosh, that was so good, huh? He loves it, you know. And so you want to be, you know, the head honcho in charge, and he's just waiting for me right now, you know. So that's a powerful thing to, let's see if I can get there again. All right. So, yeah, like I said, if you have any questions, come here, Gussie. Let's dance. Yeah, let's dance. you know, you can teach them cute tricks like that, or to open and close a door, to pull a rope on the fridge and get rescue medicine, to retrieve or anything. Nothing is out of your dog's wheelhouse as far as what you can do to focus on what they're responding to and what they, you know, the types of toys that they like and the types of games that they like. You know, a tug of war or a fetch are a really powerful game. And, you know, he has buttons right here, so we're going to be doing some playing. Do you want to play? Push it. Push it. Push it. Push it.
Yeah, let's play.
Yeah, let's play. So, to me, this is the sign for, you know, yeah, let's play. Just praise, you know. It's ASL worthy.
Yeah,
let's play. Yeah. He's wanting it. He's so... so invested in what that coconut is for him and in his dietary supplements, you know. So that's such a powerful thing.
Yeah, let's play. Yeah.
So I press it, he presses it. That's my voice, which is kind of weird, but I always wonder what each breed or each dog's voice is. But yeah, leave any comments. Good boy, water. So I'm gonna go press that button because that's part of that water is part of his daily routine and like what the buttons mean. And you know, always put the, you know, pee pee poo poos or the potty button or let's go or you know, whatever you want to call that. Just make sure it's something that and you know, in public you don't feel weird for saying that, you know. So just make sure you're comfortable with that. And he's such a happy puppy. Oh my gosh. Yeah, good boy. And so he can stay here and I can kind of check his front paws. Yeah, what a good boy.
What a good puppy.
And it's really important to cuddle with your dog too, you know. A lot of people do, but a lot of people don't. Especially if they're bigger or they're smaller and you have to get on the ground or you have to, you know, do those sorts of things. Go get in your kennel. And so what I'm going to do is, you know, create like zones essentially in the kennel. Just to kind of tie everything up. You know, this is a 30-minute segment that you can watch at your leisure when it's convenient for you. And what a good boy. All the way. Yeah, good boy. Down. Yeah, good boy, stay. And so it's just really important to have that comfort level. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn his bed to the side, and so it's gonna be half of the kennel down. Good boy. Okay, come here. Good boy. Half of the kennel. Where it's warm and nice and comfy. And it has those clothes in there. And then this is gonna be, you know, you can find an old yoga mat and fold it into fourths and then put that underneath. And bam. You got like a little bit of cushion right there too. And you're creating three zones, you know, kind of like a sleeping zone in the back that's kind of warm, you know, something up front that's kind of cooler. And it can actually extend a little bit further, you know, but you want to be able to close that gate too. So, And to create that final area for the food to be able to walk around and kind of pace, but be kind of contained too. It's really powerful.
Yeah, yeah, it's good. It's so good. Yes, you do. Yeah.
Good boy. Oh, yeah, you want to dance?
Let's dance.
Okay, off. Yeah, so that powerful training there too. To be off. You wanna go pee pee poo poos? Wanna go outside? Where's your button?
Where's your button? Oh no, it's not here.
Yeah, go sit. Good boy. So I'm gonna get his collar on and everything. And
let's play.
You want to play? Okay, let's go outside and play. Good boy.
So, I don't know, playing is important in the relationship from your dog to the food and the, you know, what that means to them. Good boy. Just checking, making sure there's no snags. And also, you know, feeling your dog's tummy and, you know, making sure that they don't have any cancerous or precancerous. Yeah, we're going to go outside and go play. Yeah, we're going to go play. Yeah, play. Anytime they do that bow like that. Yeah. Yeah, we're going to go play. So like I said, if you have any questions, I'm more than happy to walk you through anything, do a Skype lesson, do one-on-one physical lessons. And your home, that's the most powerful place, the least distraction possible. And the most reward, because, you know, you want them to be good in your space. You want them to honor your space. And you want to be highest on that totem pole, you know. If there are levels, you want to be the pack leader. And you want everyone else to be the pack leader. So it's kind of like a 2-to-1 ratio thing, like the titration on the food, you know. You want that new food to be more, you know, him excited about that and wanting to earn... You know, earn every single piece of kibble. You know, every small piece of kibble. And he's rolling on the floor, you know? He's rolling on the floor, ready to go play. You know? And he's looking back. So I'm not looking at him, I'm looking at you, because that's the focus, you know? So our dogs need to learn how to wait. And yes, we're going to play, you know, very, very much like a forever toddler. Yeah, we're going to play. Hold on. Wait. Right? Wait. And for, you know, waiting for that whining to stop, let's say. And then going to do the thing. So that's what I'm going to do. And like I said, I hope you're doing well. And this video message from the past, you know, I wish you well in your training journeys and with your fur baby. And, you know, you can train any animal, really, if you think about the psychology of operant conditioning. Look up operant conditioning and, you know, or, you know, positive training, you know, solutions. It's really powerful, especially for dogs. So, all right. Peace, you guys.